to the Hall of Fame was his running mate by the Riverwalk for 13 seasons, who ranks among the best big men of all time, Tim Duncan, Manu Ginobili.
Hear my heart pounding a little bit. Are you sure you don't want to do this? I know you love the spotlight. Yeah. Okay. All right. Whew. Amazing. Those videos get you, man. Incredible. It's been a long journey. In players like me, individual accomplishments are team honors. I'm not here because I was super special. I'm here because I was part of two of the most important teams of the 2000s, with the Spurs winning four NBA championships. Yeah. And with my Argentinian national team winning gold in 2004. Yeah. Adding there a EuroLeague one in Virtus Bologna, Coach Messina. And you got the reason why I'm here. But today, I also want to mention and talk about the teams that were not that successful, but for me were fundamental stepping stones to get here. Without those steps, I was not here today. And it all started at age 6, 7, in a little club team in Bahía Blanca, one block away from my home, so I spent there a lot of time. And my dad was, you know, the president of that team. He was one of the founders. He was always there. He was not working. He was in the club. My two brothers played there, older brothers. They were always there, too. My mom was the coach. No, she wasn't the coach. I'm kidding. She couldn't play. She didn't know anything about basketball. But she would pick me up from school at noon. She would feed me, help me cross the street, and let me just go play all day long, all the way till dinner. And I would dribble, shoot, dribble, shoot, dribble, shoot, make friends 6, 7 hours a day. And it was the perfect, the ideal spot to strengthen and develop my passion and love for the game in a very healthy and familiar environment. So I thank everybody that was part of that side of my life. From there, I played till 18. And at 18, I became a pro. I said, whoa, I wasn't that special, but coach that is here called me up. I said, oh, yes, I'm going. Of course. And, you know, I was first with Andino, La Rioja, then back in my hometown with Estudiantes, and, you know, playing in front of my family and friends at the highest stage in Argentinian basketball was a blast, and I loved every minute of it. I even had the pleasure to play with my brother Seppo, that gave me every single ball, and we had a blast. Everybody that was part of my Argentinian experience, coaches, players, thank you so much. Gradual growth and development came the first call to be part of the national team, and with it the attention and the possibility to go overseas, and Italy was the first stop. Viola Reggio Calabria, with a coach that really trusted me in tough moments, great veteran leaders that showed me how it's done, and it was a fantastic first step in European basketball. Then the jump to Virtus Bologna, where I was coached by Ettore Messina, and he basically taught me what it was necessary to get some W's and championships, and we learned and fast. Thank you, coach. The NBA moved from being an unreachable dream, to a realistic goal after playing for you and the wonderful group of teammates that I had, and we were successful enough to to win that EuroLeague. The Italian experience for me was so valuable. That's where I became not only the player that I ended up becoming here in the NBA, but also the man. So I appreciate everybody that was part of my Italian experience. During those years, I was still in Reggio Calabria. One time I was playing with the national team, and I get a call saying that I was selected by the San Antonio Spurs with the number 57. I said, "What?" That I could not believe it, and I'm literal. I could not believe it because I thought it was a mistake, that it was a language thing that they thought. Yeah, I had zero expectations, zero. Never had a conversation with the Spurs. My agent never told me that I could have been drafted. I had no fancy suit, no hat, no press conference, no nothing. I got no clue that it was happening. I didn't even know what San Antonio was in the world. Zero. But you pretty much know that side of the story. The Spurs were one big, strong, supportive family for me. 16 years. Sixteen years playing for the same coach with mostly the same players representing the same colors and city. So many wins, losses, so many friends, so many incredible experiences. And for that, I got a lot of people to thank. Of course, you got some obvious ones. Pop here, what can I say, man? I'll be short this time, but you've been so important for me and my family on and off the court that I'll never be able to thank you enough. Thank you. The one next to me, one of the best players to ever play the game, but also one of the best teammates. Man, I learned so much about you, how to be a leader, how to be an example on the court and off the court, so appreciate you, T. TP, we had our priorities straight, man. We never let our egos get in the way. We knew when it was your time, when it was my time, when it was his time, that was most of the times. For sure, you got a little bit of time, I got a little bit of time, most of the time, but we got it done, we got the job done, man. It was a pleasure. You guys know, these three guys will get you a lot of wins. All-stars, MVPs, best coach ever, whatever. But to win a championship and to become a real team, you need a whole bunch of other little pieces in place. And we had a lot of them. And I repeat, we have a lot of them. And here there are a few. Bruce Bowen, you made my job easier, man. You guarded everybody, yours, mine, his, everybody, and did it well. Thank you. Matt Bonner, wherever you are, I'm not going to forget you this time. You were a fantastic teammate. So many fun times. Buddy, Thiago, Bobo, you made those trips fun, man. I love you. Finn and Bones, great veterans in my position. I learned a lot from you, and I had a blast playing with you. Wherever you are, Finn, I know you're here. Fabri, out there, my ideal teammates. Thank you, brother. And I could keep going and going and going with 100 names because I had a lot of them, but I appreciate you all, and I'm being completely honest. Love sharing teams with you. We had a blast preparing those games, going to those dinners, winning together and losing together. It was fantastic. Thank you. When you talk about the Spurs organization, you cannot only name players. The organization is way more than that. It's the ability to find highly qualified people that fit the culture. Tom James, Will Sevenning, and Alisa Rodriguez, 25 years in the organization. Amazing people. assistant coaches, video coordinators, trainers, physios, equipment managers, GM, RC, wherever you are. You are as important in all this as the first three I mentioned. Thank you. Thank you for selecting me. Thank you for bringing me. Thank you for keeping me. I really appreciate what you, Pop, the whole family, and the whole Spurs ownership did for the city, for the community, and for all of us. I appreciate you. Thank you very much. The crazy thing about my career is that while all of this was happening with the Spurs 16 years, at the same time in parallel, I was having another career. And it was as nurturing, as fulfilling, as exciting and fun as the one with the Spurs. And it's with my national team in Argentina. A few of the guys are here. I could go and start talking about you individually nonstop for a long time. But I'll stick with what we always done, is to do it as a team. And there's nothing I value more than that. I appreciate how we run together so much, man. The championships, of course, but the disappointments also. They got us together. The conversations, the terrible trips, the late dinners, the early breakfasts, the jet lag. It was all worth it. I got you guys. I love you. That's friendship. That's brotherhood. I think it's been amazing. I'm looking forward to more adventures off the court now with you guys. I also want to thank the NBA for giving us this extraordinary stage to do what we love. David Stern first, Adam Silver now, and their wonderful team. Best sports league in the world, period. Thank you. Fans everywhere. Everywhere I've ever played, for your constant support, affection, and boundless passion, I felt your love on a daily basis. Thank you very much. And now allow me just 1 minute to address my family in Spanish. I may get a little emotional here, but bear with me. Sepo y Lea, mis hermanos, gracias por aclararme el camino. Gracias por la inspiración. Me empujaron de chiquito porque yo quería ser como ustedes. Papá. ¿Cómo me hubiese gustado que estuvieras acá? Y puedas entender lo que está pasando hoy. Mi primer fiel y más grande seguidor. Te extraño mucho, viejito. Te extraño. Mamá, sé que estás mirando por ahí. Me llevó a tener tres hijos varones para entender los sacrificios que hiciste por nosotros durante tanto tiempo. El esfuerzo, la dedicación, el amor en actos, la libertad de elegir. Gracias. Manny, Luca, Dante, and Nico. As you heard, a lot of things happened to me in my career, but if I had to choose one moment where stop time and enjoy forever, it's right now with you. Doing what we do, our time together, our trips, our rides, our nights, our everything. I love what we are, I love what we accomplished, I love what you are. I love you guys so much. And I think I'm the last one here. So thank you for to the hall and the whole class of 2022. It's been a pleasure. Thank you all for being here and looking forward to more adventures together.